41 years ago, convention weekend, which was the first part of June in Australia, that David and I both received the Holy Spirit speaking in tongues and got baptized for immersion. I'll just tell you a bit of a funny story of what happened at the convention. I'm always thinking when I go in that, you know, this is great, everything's already organized, it's on a schedule. This is probably the first year David did not get a schedule ahead of time. And anyway, David wants to talk to everybody on the way in. Everybody. I just want to go in and get seats because there's like 1,600 people there. Anyway, just before we went in, David got a text from the guy that's organizing everything and said, I need you to go to the left of the stage right now. So I went up there and I said, Remember, what do you want? And he said, You're first on for your testimony. I said, Really? Because I had no idea. Anyway, so we're going up on stage and he gave us all the instructions. There were three of us who were doing it at that time. So we got up there, and while we were waiting, I said to the guy next to me, Did you know you were giving your testimony before today? He said, Yes, my pastor told me on Wednesday. Didn't your pastor tell you? That's quite often the case, but in this case, it was not because he did not know either. So praise the Lord. Always happy to give my testimony because God has done so many wonderful things in my life. David and I had just gotten married a few months before we heard the gospel, and I was on the search for peace and joy and happiness. Went to any groups, any psychiatrist, psychologist, took medication, anything that was going to find this peace and joy and happiness within. We were happily married, but there was still something missing, and I didn't think it was God because I was brought up Presbyterian and then changed to Episcopal Church because that's what my ex-husband wanted to do, and I just sort of went along with it. So when we went to Australia, tried to go to church there, but it was not the same, and we just sort of we just stopped going. So living away from God and away from the influence of family and that sort of thing, the God was just not part of our lives. But I praise the Lord that He called me and showed me that there's the only way is through the scriptures, and it was so simple when I heard it, it seemed too easy to believe that this was the right way. And so I really struggled with it at first. But, and even when I said God was not part of our lives, we chose a wedding service that did not mention God because we didn't know what the answers were. The service was very new age and all that. And that we invited neighbors to. It was an outside service right beside, it was in a park right next to the house that we had been living in. So, praise the Lord. God changed all that around. And when we came to the Lord, and the neighbors, because they knew what we were like before, and they wondered what things were, how things would be. And so, of course, told them all about it, but unfortunately, they were interested. But praise the Lord, my life was filled with music. I thought that was my goal in life, was to get through all this music. And I was putting that first because there was nothing else that I was really interested in at the time. And as I was doing that and studying, I had only a few months left in the course I was doing because I'd done so many different ones, and every time I achieved a goal, I thought that would be the last time, and then I would have to go on and think, no, I'll be the next one. And so that's where I was at, 5 years part-time doing this course. And when I went into my piano teacher's recital one day, God just showed me that I did not belong there. It was like people praising people. And that piece of paper that I was striving for was so temporary compared to what God had done for me. It was just so clear to me. So I left music school that day saying to the head of the music department, I'm sorry, I'm not coming back. I'm sorry to let other people in because I have commitments to other people. But I just couldn't go on. And I just felt such a peace and joy after that. And I really felt like I entered the rest and I know what I did. And praise the Lord, it was no problem putting God first after that. Whereas before, if it worked out, I would get to meetings, but music was always my priority at that time. Praise the Lord, we know God's first, everything falls into place. Heal pain fevers, sinus problems, depression, all the things I used to take medication for, just set free, and just a wonderful peace and joy. And I learned early on in my walk how important prayer and fasting is, because even when we were first came along, it took me a while to get the vision and the picture about it. And I didn't go to the first one. They went by myself. And one of the sisters came up to me the next day and said, it was such a blessing and a mystery. I was so convicted by that. And I thought, if God had a blessing for me, then I missed it. There must be something wrong with my attitude. So I prayed about it. And the next time, God got me through it. And it's just been a great joy. And every time through prayer and fasting, many miracles. We just had a wonderful time in Australia. The Lord totally blessed it. It was probably the best time we've ever had. And we sort of organized our trip a little bit differently to not be rushed all the time, but to visit smaller assemblies in the country. And it was just a wonderful time of fellowship. And they all send their regards, and we just had a great time witnessing where we went as well. And it's just exciting to do the Lord's work wherever we are. And I just praise the Lord. I praise the Lord that He brought us here, even though it wasn't my desire initially, but God totally changed that as well. It's such a blessing. So I just give Him all the praise and glory. Amen.